page, so my mark. Ready, set, go. I'm ashamed that I used to shift the blame when I hadn't done my part.
Like, maybe today.
So, really even took the time to just stop.
No, not today.
Maybe today. That was before. Today feels like but a good day. But why not
start? Do what? These nuts. I'm
not gonna go there, Rob. I'm just gonna leave you alone. You're still kind of new. I'll tell you, man. I missed you guys, man.
Well, we glad you're back, bro.
Man, you guys did fantastic last week, bro.
I appreciate that, man. You think so?
No, you guys did. You guys brought up some really good points, man, that I wish I was a part of.
You were a part of it. You were in the chat.
Yeah, there was a conversation about that whole who would make a good gambit, and when you guys brought up fucking Shia LaBeouf, I was like, damn, because he's a fantastic actor. I gotta give it to him. Even at a young age, he was doing really good, and you know what I'm saying, when he came out with that movie. Hold on a minute. Let me switch screens real quick. Oh!
Wifey vetoed that. Wifey said that was not happening.
It would be a fantastic cast. However, she's right, though. It's not going to happen. It would never happen before.
What about, I just thought of this one. What about Jake Gyllenhaal?
You have to let Gyllenhaal for a second, too. It kept coming back to Channing, and that's the problem. Like, I can't take Channing.
No, Channing won't even do it now.
I'm surprised I haven't broke
any bones. Take it easy, hold on a minute. To see me like this, I hid myself at home and I held tight to myself as always.
All
right, why is it not showing me anything? Oh, that's right, because I have the fucking thing off.
Hey Vic, you really liked that wrestling promo, didn't you?
Bro, that shit was nice. If I can get in front of, if you ever really want to get serious about those fucking kind of tactics, man, I got a friend of mine who does a Dusty Rhodes impression out of this fucking world. Like, he gets all into the lisp, the whole nine. I'm like, God damn. And that's how I actually I met my boy. He was doing that impression. I was like, you just did a fucking fantastic Dusty Rhodes. He's like, oh, you get into the wrestling. I'm like, God damn, bro, really? You just go way into character.
Yeah, I wanted to switch my rock impressions better, but Gus wouldn't let me be the Rock.
Shut the fuck up. That's not how it went down. That's not how it went down. It went down like this. Let me tell you how that promo went down. We're leaving the gym, usual. We're talking, like, hey, we gotta cut this promo, right? He's like, yeah, let's do it. I'm like, all right, what are you gonna do? He's like, oh, I'm gonna do a Macho Man impression.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Right? So,
it turned into Hulk Hogan.
I was like, okay, cool. I don't want to do Hulk Hogan. I didn't want to be like, oh, yeah, brother, you know? I didn't want to do that. So I was like, okay, just go. I'm gonna jump in. He's like, no, what are you doing? Because he sees me playing with my phone, right? And I'm trying to queue up the Rock's theme song, but it wasn't loading in Apple Music. So then he's like, hurry the fuck up, Gus, let's do it. I was like, okay, hold on, I'm getting the song. He's like, what song are you looking for? I was like, I'm getting the Rock's theme song. He goes, oh, no. If anybody's going to be the Rock, it's going to be me. And da-da-da-da. I was like, shut the fuck up, start talking, and let me do what I got to do. Like, I didn't tell him what I was planning on.
Hey, now, wait a minute. Most of that shit, let me just say, you did stop. You're like, well, fine, you could be the Rock. So don't fucking lie.
You were getting your panties in a bunch. I don't
want to set the world on fire. Yeah, but think about it. He's bigger. He's got more tats. He's got the high ground. Like,
I don't give a shit.
This is why he should be the Rock.
Hey, he called Macho Man. So he's going to be Macho Man.
Gus just called playground rules on me. He's like, motherfucker, in pretend land, you just said you were Macho Man and then Hulk Hogan, so guess what? You're going to be Hulk Hogan.
And Gus, I promise, if he ever tries to steal Rey Mysterio from you, I got you. He can never have Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio is yours.
Hey, and that's fine. I'm probably the same height as him. But either way, my point is this. So I go in there, okay, and I cue up the music. He's like, Gus, before you come in and do the rock, you gotta make sure that you let me talk. And then, so he kind of threw me off a little bit. I was like, you know what, fuck this, I'm gonna go Attitude Era on there. So he starts talking, and I'm standing on the side like this, with my phone, like, kind of aiming it. And then as soon as, like, he's really getting into it, I hit play on that bitch, and I jumped in.
I gotta ask real quick. Rob, how tall are you?
6'2", 6'3" on a good day.
Yeah, 6'3".
So he's about, me and him about the same height.
He's bigger than me. Yeah, he's bigger than me.
So we gonna do what? We gonna do a Bill Goldberg Rikishi frickin'.
It's a Rikishi mother. Wow,
gentlemen, the introduction is rolling.
Who's gonna be Rikishi? Look, I can't take Rey Mysterio from Gus. I can't take Rikishi from you. That's just how it is.
Wow.
Welcome back. That's not hate. I just don't want to wear a diaper.
Right there. Reminds me of the old days.
Questions?
So you're saying that Josh will look better in a man thong? I'll
give you the answer to that.
Yeah, probably.
I probably. Saturday.
Don't mess with the bull, young man. You'll get the horns.
Do you fool, or do we need to just shave away for you to make a new shank?
You know what we ought to do for Bob?
Let's go!
We should get him a nice back. Because that stuff is like currency in prison. That and ass.
So,
I said,
you got detention.
What the fuck?
You screwed up.
Yeah, I know,
maybe you were trying to be cool. You take it from a guy who's been frozen for 65 years. The only way to really be cool is to follow the rule.
You through?
How many is that? That's 7 including the moment when we first came in. You asked us to burn here. We'll be back, man.
That's
awesome.
Nice.
Use your time to study.
Ah, sweet.
Let's start the show.
Let's start the show.
That is the most epic birth cake ever. I only want this birthday cake from this point forward.
Birth cake,
uterine liberation day, whatever you want to call it. That is the cake that I want. I want the same figures. I want Obi-Wan to be standing there dusty and dirty each year. I want Anakin to be melted even more through the candles. This is the only cake that I want. The question I have is, Gus, did you get to have some of this cake?
Negative.
Good evening, gentlemen. Good evening, everybody.
First and foremost, let me go ahead and tell you, I got to give you big shots out, man, because I sent that picture not even less than 2 hours ago. So all that editing you do, my man, my hats off, bro. I know I look rugged right about now, but hats off to you, my man. Props for that shit.
No, we're getting
Yo, like, what's going on with the beard, bro? Like, it looked like you were trying to go with the Amish beard and bailed out at the last second.
All right, so fuck you. let's just put it out there. I had caught COVID for the past week, and so I'm catching up, and my face looked so bad, you know what I'm saying? And like I shaved it really, really low, and when I realized how low I shaved it, I was like, I'm fucking too late now. I'll just keep going, and now I got this Dominican look, so.
Dominican? No, bro. You look
that's
like
one
you
thing. That's one thing I hate about having the beard, man.
You want to know what I honestly think it is? Remember that episode of Parks and Recreation where Tom gets caught up with Tammy and she rides his mustache off? Like, I think my man was in COVID for 2 weeks, but it's a
lot. Oh, man, he got off COVID and got mustache rides.
He got that mustache ride.
I'm so glad she's not watching
Wants
this
mustache
right
ride.
Now.
That's what it was. Got him.
Well, hey, listen,
I'm glad
the wife
you are fluent in cunnilingus.
Hey, I'll take it. All fucking day.
Pinche Yuli, what is up? What's going on, Yuli? Yo, most insane cart driver I know. Like, I want to challenge this cat now. Like, I've seen the videos. Like, I've seen him driving go-karts. Does he go over
what's
to the next spot on power
Yuli?
Line?
Yeah, that's the one he goes to. Funny story. So after our workout, I typically do a 2 mile run, right? And I'm starting to jog, and all of a sudden I hear a honk behind me, and I was like, shit. I was like, who is it now? And Yuli pulls up next to me, and I talked to him for like 30 seconds, and I was like, yo, make sure you tune in. Thanks for tuning in, bro. I hope you enjoy the show. Don't forget to talk shit in the chat, because you like to talk shit.
Yeah, talk some shit, homie. Let's get the show started. I'm Vic Nasty. It's a wonderful evening. I've been dealing with blood pressure issues all week, but I'm here. It's a blockbuster night. I'm with my brothers. I'm hanging out. I'm going to ask these gentlemen just introduce themselves, and let's go ahead and get into the fuckery.
Ladies first.
Damn.
Yeah, your mustache is the shortest. Right. I mean, that answer's pretty obvious. Come on.
Facts. I'll give you that one.
Your face got rolled like a Bronco. Right, you the most woman pretty here much. Right now.
Hey, listen, this is what happens when you stay away from your wife. You know what I'm saying, for over a week, bro. Like, I felt like I was in jail. So, Josh, a.k.a. Beast, a.k.a. Tap Out Beast, you know, I missed you guys, man. I was missing out last week. I felt, you know what I'm saying, I felt like, you know what I'm saying, I needed to be on there, but I didn't want you guys to hear me hacking up a lung and shit and, you know, hitting my damn fucking asthma pump and shit every once in a while. So, but yo, I'm back. I'm with my brothers. I'm with my family. So, yeah, I appreciate you guys, man. Fuck COVID.
Welcome back,
sir.
That's hot.
That's what you get for drinking tea. And next time, do it with your pinky up, fucker.
My bad. I just, it's a big fucking mug, bro.
Yeah, I noticed. I mean, that shit looks gigantic in your hand. I don't even want to know how much liquid's in there.
It's like half the cup, though.
Fuck. All right, Gus, go.
All you're missing is the two girls.
Gus, say hi to the wonderful people.
Hi, wonderful people. What can I say? Come on, it is El Doc Goose in the house. Kind of thick, kind of thick, you know what I'm saying? Check me out on my Instagram.
Coach.
What's up, guys? This is Coach Rob, a.k.a. Coach Beard, a.k.a. Drax the Lifter, the resident white boy on the podcast, the token minority on the podcast. Here bringing you your motivation, and as I told Gus today, he's only a monster because I created that monster. So you're welcome for that.
Ooh, well, point of contention and point of historical footnote. I think you're the blackest dude on here, just to keep it 100. You make it the most black decisions. You're the most whitest dude that I know that makes the most blackest decisions. We're gonna talk that offline, but I'm telling you, like, straight up, like, I got a lot of respect for you, my G. You said Drax the Lifter. Are you no longer Brax the Lifter? Have we just taken over the name?
I'm a little nasally. Okay, I'm a little congested.
I just don't know if we co-opted the name. Like, if we're taking the name because he don't want it no more, then we'll just take it now. We'll call it.
I am not going toe-to-toe with Batista. That dude would crush me.
Gus is a puto and so is Vic. Yeah, I'm a puto. Yo, I think you're the kind of puto that drives around power lines just looking for people you know to challenge him. Like, you drive within a half-mile radius of this track. This is this big-ass track. Like, it looks like a BJ's, but it's a racetrack. And, yo, he's got videos all on his Instagram where he's just dusting people doing Mario Kart shit. Like, so, no, I'm not trying to see you in your bag of bananas, son. You a puto, too. I miss you. I hope to see you real soon when I get down there. Dude, I'm just going to jump us right in. McDonald's is leaving. I'm calling an audible. McDonald's is leaving Russia. Rob, talk to me. Hold on.
So, in an effort, I guess, to McDonald's to be, I don't know, have a moral value, which is McDonald's. I didn't know they had moral values, but they decided to pull out all McDonald's, and not pull out like pull out from sex, but pull out all McDonald's from Russia. McDonald's, no more. Russians cannot get a Big Mac anymore. They are done, son.
Yo, Frank, if you're watching, your tactical tots idea might have just got like, if there was ever a situation where I would want to stop fighting a war, it'd be the fact that I couldn't get a Big Mac or some McNuggets. Like, is McVladimir's gonna show up? Like, I told you, a potato
honestly, Mac and potato honestly Mac. Though, I don't think. I mean, I don't know, and I'd have to see a, I'd have to see a poll, but I don't think Russians cared. I mean,
it's a point of pride now. Like, it's becoming a point of like.
I'll be honest. Contention. I don't even think it's like McDonald's is bad here. Like, you know, this shit's unhealthy. I mean, I'm pretty sure Brax has not touched the McDonald's floor in like fucking years. But from what
motherfucker, at least at the least,
oh shit,
7-8 months since I've been in a McDonald's. I do Matthew McDonald. At least.
At least you honest. At least you honest. At least you honest. You're not going with the whole, yeah, man, I haven't been there shitting. You know, this show's so unhealthy.
No, the wife, the wife gets a hankering once in a while, like every blue moon for McDonald's. She just loves that greasy, nasty. So if she goes in on McDonald's, I'll get a double quarter pounder with cheese, milkshake.
You
get
the worst one. Oh, okay, never mind. Nah. This motherfucker's just going big or go home. Okay, I got you all day. But, I mean, like, from what I'm understanding and, you know, from what I'm hearing from different people and shit overseas, you know, whether it's Russia or Europe itself, McDonald's isn't as unhealthy as it is here.
Oh, McDonald's is the shit.
Oh, that's true. McDonald's is true.
Oh, bro, it's fucking like gourmet, bro, from what I'm fucking seeing all over goddamn YouTube, bro.
Okay.
You got to remember, in Europe, GMOs are illegal. They're not supposed to put that in their food.
Nah, Beard's had the best experience. Beard, did you have McDonald's in Japan when you were in Japan?
No. Oh. Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Oh, look, he's lying. That's how he's cutting out.
Oh, my God.
He had it.
It's a lot greasier than Kentucky Fried Chicken. Had some weird shit on the menu.
That was not Kentucky Fried Chicken.
And I had a
fried dog.
They take their KFC. They take their KFC cereal.
Here's a fun fact: I had Pizza Hut and the cheese. So Pizza Hut in Egypt, I did have that too.
Hmm.
No,
okay, you know what? Since you brought up Egypt, I got a question for you. I heard like it's horrible for tourists out there in Egypt. Oh, he has that shocked look on his face. Look at that.
In what way?
Like, okay, so again, I'm following YouTube and shit, you know, because that's my get out when I was, you know, locked down. and this guy,
hold
like,
on, tell me out. Are we getting a whole new Josh? Like, after week and a half in COVID, like, are you coming out like YouTube season video game ready? Like,
bro, I found I watched a video for a new show that I gotta fucking get into, man. I want to check it out because my daughter just showed me about it and shit. But yeah, man, I was catching up on shows, and so I was like, damn, I got nothing better to do. So yeah, YouTube and fucking Fire Stick.
No, I'm
okay. Did Brax fix his?
Nope, he still got Comcast out there.
So yeah,
he's got Xfinity. Oh,
shit. Like, it sounds like a remix right now. Like, I'm about to fucking do a DJ shit right now.
Why so serious?
Got that complete. Somebody get a screenshot of that.
His shirt says not today. It looks like his internet's not working today.
He's got T-Mobile home internet.
Well, nah, like, yo, straight up, like, even the 7-Elevens in Japan have, like, next level shit. Like, we get the shittiest McDonald's that exists. The worst of the worst funds they get going to move. Don't know what's going on. All right, so Rob's he's taking an audible and he's going to try to relocate. While he does that, condolences to those families, the mass shooting in Buffalo. We usually take a rest in peace moment.
Yes.
Let's take that moment now. You know, we're not going to comment on it tonight. We're not going to show video. It exists on the internet. If you really want to see what happened, you can see what happened. I mean, it's just the fuckery continues. But what's most important is rest in peace to those. So we're going to take a moment of silence here. Rest in peace, people. Something that came at the end. We wanted to talk about ghost stories and breakfast cereals while Rob's not here, because Rob seems to have the most ridiculous ghost stories.
And probably the most ridiculous breakfast cereal.
Let's do breakfast cereals. Yeah, I'm excited
about it. You want to do breakfast?
Yeah, because Rob will come back in and then he'll tell us his three breakfast cereals and he'll make sense as to why he chose them, and then I'll feel real shitty about my decisions. but I'm going to go first. My first, if you had my number one draft choice, but there's an addendum. I've got to buy powdered sugar to go with it. I want frosted.
Oh, God.
Frosted flakes. Why do you got to buy powdered sugar? Yo, because if you got 80% Coke, why wouldn't you want it to be 100%? Like, the fuck kind of question is this?
This nigga want to be stingy with all the sugar. Like, nah, nigga, that's plain enough.
And not even the regular confectioner's sugar. Have y'all seen they make 10-ton confectioner's sugar?
This nigga want that sugar cane shit.
I want the puree, son.
This nigga's killing the fucking messenger. He's like, I don't want the middleman, nigga. I want to go straight to the source. This guy's going fucking American Gangsta on everybody with this shit.
Yo, hold on. I got you. Like, yo, fam, it's the most ridiculous shit ever. And you don't use a lot.
Damn, like, Vinci doesn't hold fucking punches, bro.
That's why you look like that. Fuck yeah, that's why I look like that. What made you bald, nigga?
Oh.
Yeah. Yo,
fun fact, this is Rob's actual toilet.
I believe it. Oh, yeah. Yeah,
oh, that's so nice. Yo, 10 times powdered sugar. There's 25 pounds there. That could get me through a lifetime of Frosted Flakes. So, Rob, we decided to start with breakfast cereals. Breakfast cereals. Yeah, shut up. There's a lot of moving parts. I got called fat. I'm calling a dude out for being bald. I'm trying to explain why I know that my cereal choices are going to be horrible and they're going to make me feel worse about myself in the morning.
What were your three?
My first was Frosted Flakes, but with the addendum that I want 10 times confectioner's sugar to go along with it, so that this way I could just sprinkle. Because why have 80% cocaine when I can have 100% cocaine? Just give me all the sugar.
Diabetes.
Diabetes.
Diabetes. I got diabetes.
Yo, somebody help us get a sound. Somebody help us get an Elgato sound deck so I can have that loaded up and I can just press that button and go diabetes whenever I say some stupid shit like that. So that's my first draft pick. I'm taking Frosted Flakes. Who's going next?
I'm going to go with Cocoa Puffs.
Cocoa Puffs.
I prefer Cocoa Krispies over Cocoa Puffs.
Yeah, I was about to. Yeah, Cocoa Krispies all fucking day.
But
when the milk absorbs into the Cocoa Puff and it just gets a little soft, yeah, that's
so. So you ready for this? You reason why fucking Gus likes Cocoa Puffs?
Oh, here we go.
Loves
here
the taste go. Of fucking chocolate balls in his mouth.
Oh.
Yo,
damn.
My man was in COVID. He waited for you. He thought about what you were doing.
He waited.
He waited for you to say Cocoa Puffs.
Yeah, he did. He probably got a notebook over there and shit that he
bro, just gonna, sitting there, just like, I'm sitting there like a freestylist right now, but like, yeah.
Yeah, he had you
see?
Set up.
He's got notes.
I miss you guys, man.
I love that. That's how he justifies it.
My first is Golden Grahams. I'm going with the Golden Grahams.
Golden Grahams.
I love me some damn Golden Grahams.
See, it's sweet, but it's not super sweet. If you save the milk, you get a little bit of extra sweetness. See, this is why I'm going to feel bad about myself once I see my next choice. Oh, so Cocoa Puffs, Golden Grahams. I took Frosted Flakes. Did we hear what B's first choice was?
Yeah, Golden Crisps. Cocoa Krispies.
Cocoa Krispies. Like the Pebbles?
Yeah, Cocoa Pebbles. It's the same fucking thing.
I might have to co-sign that one, and the only reason why is that Cocoa Puffs shrink, homie. Like, when you put them in your mouth, like, they kind of evaporate and melt. And
you get shrinkage when you put them in your mouth, huh?
Yeah, it's a thing. I'm trying to find Yuli's photo. Yuli asked me to pull up my Hitler hairdo. I don't think we've ever addressed my Hitler hairdo, so I'm going to let Beard make an executive decision and confirm if I had a Hitler hairdo at this point. And if I did, then I will own it and I will never have this hairdo again.
Oh, no. Yo, Yuli's going in the vault with shit, bro.
Yeah, Yuli chose violence. Everybody chose violence but me today.
Bro, no. Let the stream roll on and you'll get yours, trust me.
There we go.
All right, while we're waiting for the picture, what's option number two?
Well, it's up to me to choose, right?
Yep, your turn.
Fuck. Cocoa Krispies. The cookie ones? Yeah.
Ooh,
Cookie Crisp.
Cookie Crisp.
Yeah.
So good, you forget the motherfucking name.
Yeah.
Because I'm old.
That's the excuse we're going with? Gotcha.
Yeah, that is the excuse we're going with.
My second choice is the Captain Crunch with Crunch Berries, scraping the top of the roof of the mouth.
Ooh.
Yep, we're choosing violence today. We're choosing violence. I'm going to go because Mariano, my son, also loves this cereal. Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Okay.
He calls them crunchies. That's the name for them. So in the morning, he says, "Papa, I want some crunchies." I was like, "I got you, homie."
All right, so I got one Honey Smacks.
Ooh,
honey. Dig them.
Really?
Yeah, man.
They look like corn nuts.
Why does it so, fun fact, when I was younger, you like my grandmother nuts, always had the Honey Smacks up in her cupboard, man. With Dig'em the Frog. Hell yeah.
So, fun fact about that shit, my mother was stingy as fuck with that. So, for me, when I was, whenever I was able to sneak a bowl and shit, it made it that much better for me.
Whenever I was able to sneak a bowl?
Okay. I thought you were gonna say you had the bootleg version.
Bro, that was the funny thing. So she got us fucking the puffs. Okay, they didn't even have a fucking name to it. It was puffs and you had to add sugar to the shit. Okay, so like I said, whenever I could sneak some shit, I would, and it just made it that much better.
Man, in my houses, I'm pretty sure it was like this in all Latino homes. My parents used to buy corn flakes. And I used to have to sprinkle the sugar on them to like give it that frosted flake taste. But at the end, the sugar would sit at the milk and just, you know, you drink that.
So
I feel the struggle.
So for us white folks, it was the same way with Rice Krispies. Rice Krispies and two pounds of sugar.
We can't even go past this fucking picture, my man. What in God's name were you thinking when you fucking took this goddamn picture, dog? Like, my man, like...
Oh, my God. I remember that shit.
I, Yuli, you got your like, photo, Yuli.
You got to bring up... What the hell was with the curl, though, bro?
Oh, my God.
This thing remind me of Strong Guy from fucking X Factor and shit. Marvel.
That photo, you trying too hard, kid. Why you trying so hard?
Because I was at a Metallica concert less than
like a young tryhard.
Less than like 3 months before that, I was at a Metallica concert.
Bro, insane.
Okay, so did you get your ass kicked for going to a Metallica concert with your hair like that?
Fuck no.
Back door!
I almost kicked somebody's ass. You think you're talking to, homie?
First and foremost, there was like I can hear the energy, but you had like such a monotone face. You're like, bastard.
I was tired. We lost Gus. Like, I think that's one of the moments that contributed to Gus becoming the monster that Beard made him.
So where's the picture of your boy Pinche then?
Wait, like, to be honest, that was pre-Beard. That was before I met Rob. Yeah. Yep.
That was, I'm like, Gus, why weren't you there to fight with me? And he was like, because I was in the car gassed. I had to sit down on the chair. Kind of situation.
We had general admission. This is when I was like at my biggest. And we had general admission and I had like center stage watching Metallica, and it was just a bunch of people, and all of a sudden, like, I got overheated, man. Like, I took a hit of a joint that was getting passed around, and I remember going out, standing in the state in the bleachers, and I could not just cool down to save my life. It was a horrible experience, and I had to break out.
So you took a hit of a joint, and then you were just done?
No, like, the joint came on. Who was on before Metallica? It was Avenged, was before Metallica, yeah. Right? Yeah, I took a joint. I took a hit of a joint that was getting passed around, and I just remember it was just so hot. And when Vic saw me, like, I'm dehydrated, I'm drenched in sweat, and he's like, "Where the fuck were you?" I was like, "Bro, I was dying."
Yeah, I was about to get into a fist fight. Like, I was the kind of dude that Rob would have had to take to the ground, and it was only because I was fighting for what was mine, but there was no rationality. There was no rationality. It really wasn't. Like...
And your wingman wasn't there.
His brother was there.
My brother was there.
And to be fair, we got separated long before Metallica came on.
Yeah, like hours before. They took off
and I couldn't find them. Like, I was on my own. Like, I felt bad. I almost felt like I was going to pass out in the middle of the concert.
I went looking for him, couldn't find him. Was like, all right, he'll find us. He knows we're at the front of the stage. Like, I'm sending photos of where we're at. Total story for a different night. Before you threw up at the bus, that was a different night. That was the edibles night. That was a different conversation. We talked about that one. But we're going to move right along. We haven't gotten that final round of breakfast cereal. So,
yes.
What's the be-all, end-all, Josh? Mm. What's the third choice?
My third and final choice would actually have to be cornflakes.
Plain old cornflakes.
I mean, with a fucking brand. Nah. I like Raisin Bran. Don't get me wrong, but that isn't like, you know, I gotta have that shit. To me, like, cornflakes, I remember eating that shit when I was young with like a pound of sugar, and then you know, either with cold milk, of course, or even, bro, like with warm milk. That shit actually, bro, that shit hits, man. And that'll forever always be in my top, at least top five.
So you like looking at a box with a big green cock on it.
Why has everything got to be a cock?
I had to get you back for the balls one, man. It's on opening.
I'm sure you did. You had to get me back. You saw the opening. This motherfucker.
It's not wrong. The Kellogg's rooster is a cock. I mean, there's a cock it's on green. The box.
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
All right. My top one, I'm going to have to go with Fruity Pebbles.
So you Fruity took Pebbles. Cocoa Pebbles and Fruity Pebbles.
No, I took Cocoa Puffs.
Puffs, because yeah, he likes okay. the balls.
Because like I ball. Like the balls.
Yeah, you like the mouth-melting balls. Okay.
Yes.
Fruity
Pebbles. My third is going to be Fruit Loops. Got to have some Fruit Loops.
Yeah, okay.
I forgot about Fruit Loops.
I love Toucan Sam.
Want to say some, like, mind-bending shit, but I just don't know what I would say, so I'm going to go with Lucky Charms. They're magically delicious.
They're magically disgusting.
Yeah, they are, bro.
They're not. They're actually my daughter's favorite cereal, actually.
Like, I can't do the oat one. Like, that. I remember as a kid eating that, and I would eat just the oats and save all the marshmallows to tear up at the end.
Okay, so what's y'all least absolutely hate worst cereal?
Wheaties. Grape nut.
Yeah, grape nuts.
Grape nuts.
Yeah.
Oh, Wheaties. Mine's actually Corn Pops. I can't stand some Corn Pops.
Log off.
Hi. I cannot stand Corn Pops, man. I don't like Corn Pops.
You're so lucky I don't have admin fucking roles on this one. Bitch, if we were in the other chat, I swear to God, I'd fucking lock his ass off. Corn Pops was the shit growing up.
I think they're disgusting.
I mean, I can understand if you were like, I didn't like Cheerios. But
I love Cheerios.
Yeah, who yeah, like Cheerios?
Which one was the one that was kid tested, mother approved?
Kix.
Why don't like you could have said
I like Kix. I like
Kix has no fucking taste,
bro. Cinnamon Life, that's another good cereal.
Kix is like fucking King Vitamin, if you know. Well,
Yeah, I know. I was about to bring that up. I grew up on Kaboom and King Vitamin, so you know, there for you me, go. I'm good with every other non no frills box brand you got. Like,
I would like to say an honorable mention, Honeycomb.
I love Honeycomb, bro.
Oh, yeah. I hate those. Yeah.
All right, shut up.
Yeah, Honeycombs is a no-go. Honeycombs is a no-go. Who asked if the multiverse really exists? Who wanted to know? Okay. So
I saw Doctor Strange last week. I'm caught up.
Finally!
All about goddamn time.
Hey!
I thought you talked about it on the stream. You didn't?
They spoke about it, but hey. Yeah, it's very interesting theory what they say about the dreams. I kind of like that.
Go ahead, Josh. Since my family just popped in, Game Time Entertainment, yo, he gave us a shout out, and I gotta give him props, man.
Yep.
He gave us a shout out. So, if you guys ever get a chance, man, if you guys love video games and watching Mario get his ass kicked by Bowser, bro, literally stop by his page, Game Time.
This is the Super Mario Savant.
Yes, this is the one that plays all kinds of games on Facebook that I was telling you about. Let me tell you, this guy's got his ass kicked over and over again by Bowser. Like, I've watched the stream for like 4 days straight. You know what I'm saying? Running the fucking shit, man. And I give him props, man. So, yo, he gave us a shout out. I gotta give him more. You know, gotta give it back to him, man.
Yep, agree. But to be fair, that Bowser looks like he smoked a
on
giant
crack.
Yeah, he's on crack. So, multiverse of madness. Yes, why not? Why shouldn't it exist?
So I'm gonna surprise Vic on this one, because I don't believe in the whole fucking the whole Matrix shit. However, I will say I do believe that there is a multiverse. I do believe that, you know what I'm saying, like, bro, when that shit came out, when, you know, Wong was like, so that dream of me on a cloud being chased naked, she's like, that's not fake, that's real. Like, that's a whole other thing. And I'm like, fuck, bro. Like, there's fucking dreams where I feel like I'm running through a damn house naked.
So, so did you guys ever see the old-ass movie Jet Li, the one?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Fucking yes.
So, kind of same so, think, you know, I think there is a multiverse. Space is infinite. We don't know what's out there beyond everything, and it is possible that there's other stars, moons, life. But part of the thing of the multiverse theory is that when we have deja vu, that's one of our other us experiencing the same thing we're experiencing at the same time.
So I got another theory about that whole deja vu. I don't think it's like, you know, an us, like, you know, in another time. I thought, from what I was understanding, it's you're on this right path, and, you know what I'm saying, well, I guess you're right, kind of in another, like,
it's a timeline, it's another timeline,
like, you're on the right direction, you're on that right path, like, you've been here before, you know what I'm saying, so you're just going through it, and it's like that whole fuck you Vic whole Matrix scene
red pill or blue pill, motherfucker.
I'm just sitting here enjoying my vape. Josh, I'm gonna ask you to do something for me.
Fuck, all right, go ahead.
Take your glasses off.
Ah, fuck. I'm blind. Like, I see a blur.
So now you just made a choice. Now, did that create an alternate universe where your glasses broke when you took them off? Possibly, but will you ever know? No. Every choice you make has a consequence, yes or no. So every decision we make, because string theory is basically every decision we make creates a new branch, creates a new branch, creates a new branch. Me hitting this,
puts another nail in the coffin.
Definitely puts another nail in the coffin, but shit, could create two different universes. So the multiverse concept, deja vu fucks with me because I've had deja vu, and the scientific definition of deja vu is that auditorily, you hear two things, and then visually you see two things. So the fact that they're playing off of each other creates a deja vu scenario. I don't believe that, because I've seen actual deja vu where it's like, I've seen this before. I know this exists. I had a friend who could swear to you that when he saw certain color patterns, he knew something bad was going to happen in his life within the next 72 hours. Guaranteed. And I see chat action happening, so...
Yeah, Beecher says stop spraying right on your blunts.
Wow, I don't even smoke blunts no more. I'm too old for blunts, homie. I'll occasionally pack a bowl and enjoy my views. And I'm about to get some... Wait, look. Beer just made another choice. The multiverse created.
So say you are correct. What actions would you make differently if you found it were true?
None.
The decision in itself is a decision.
Fuck that.
And because we're imperfect, we're going to create imperfect decisions. No matter what you do, you're going to create imperfect decisions.
Honestly, Beast, you probably wouldn't change. You say you'll change a decision, but every outcome, every possibility happens for a reason.
Have you seen my past?
Look, even my past, but when I start mind-fucking things and think about, well, what if I didn't do this and what if I do... Come back to the same conclusion. I still make the same decisions I made over again. From getting married to the woman that I didn't want to be with, to divorce, to everything. I wouldn't change a fucking thing. Okay. It's like that movie, and this can lead us into the next topic of Nicolas Cage. It's like that movie, The Family Man, with Nicolas Cage, where he gets a glimpse of what life would be like with the girl that he wanted to be with versus being with his family. And what happened?
Kind of what Game Tide is actually getting to. If you could tap into it, think limitless. He's like, what if you could alert your other self? Would you?
Yes.
Nope.
I would alert myself.
Nope. Yeah. Nigga, I would tap on my shoulder, smack him the other way, and be like, go that way.
So what? He could sneak up behind you and put the knife in your back? Nah, son.
Nigga.
Why would I do that to myself?
Now we're getting into Highlander. There can be only one.
There can't only be one.
Nope. I would warn myself from people, from situations, from everything. Like, I would sit down and have a very deep conversation with myself.
But just think, Gus, every moment you've been through has made you who you are today, and you are better for the bullshit that you've been through.
Yes, but you're not taking away from what you've already learned.
Right.
I wanna touch on what Game Light said. But why though? Think Rick and Morty. At some point, Morty created the fucking Cronenverse, and Rick and Morty had to walk in and just, you know what? This is where we live now. You know what I mean? At some point, it's about self-preservation, and I'm trying to say that in the most loving way, because I would never self-preserve. No, because hear it out. When I say something like self-preservation, that means me over anything else, which would include y'all. But if there was a chance for me to like push the button to save for y'all, I would probably make that move. I wouldn't be the selfish asshole that was like, hey, I need the four of y'all to push that button. I'll be outside this door. I don't see myself that way. The Nicolas Cage shit. Let's keep ourselves moving because I don't want us to get us too far off topic. And Rob was taking us somewhere. So like the Nicolas Cage movie, the one where he either can be with the shorty, it wasn't the Weatherman, it was the Family Man.
The Family Man.
Nicolas Cage. I mean, let's change the caveat of just DC. Who's the villain you want to see him play?
Oh, ooh. We were supposed to say
We said DC, bro. Man.
Let's stick
keep
with
it.
DC.
We did Marvel last week, so we gotta keep it 100. We gotta stick with DC.
Yeah,
I wasn't here for last week. No, I'm just kidding. Go ahead, let's go.
That's your fault.
And I want to say that while I think mine was good, I think Gus is actually the best. I give Gus props. We talked about this today, and I'm a little jelly because Gus's answer. We'll let him go last. So, Josh, did you have somebody?
For a villain, you know, I don't know.
All right, so for my choice, I picked from Batman was the Mad Hatter. I think he'd be a good Mad Hatter.
Yeah, I would co-sign on that. I think he'd be a good Mad Hatter.
No, I think okay. Yep. So, I don't think he would be a good Mad Hatter.
I think so.
Because he looks so like it looks so forced when he did the whole fucking oh God, Jesus Christ, Ghost Rider, when he fucking like you know had to look crazy and shit. Even when he did Face Off, that he's like, just take the face.
No, but that's where I respect him as an actor. Like, I'm telling you, man.
I think he would do a good Two-Face.
that's just too common of a. I mean, that was my first guess, but I just think that's too. I don't think he could play the Harvey Dent side of things. He'd be better than Tommy Lee Jones was as Two-Face, but I don't think he could do the Harvey Dent side. Like, who they had, the actor, I forget his name, that they had in the Bane as Two-Face was perfect.
Oh, you're talking about...
Oh, Tom Hardy?
No. You're talking about... Said Bane. No, the one in the movie...
The Bale, the Christian Bale movies. The guy that played Two-Face in the Christian Bale movies, the actor.
Oh, him. He did really good. He did good.
All right, Vic?
When you put me on DC, you limit me. Oh.
Hey, that was the original conversation.
Okay, Vic, since you the host and you the main man, who did you have Nicolas Cage as?
No, I mean, I'm willing to go DC. Just I'm trying to see. The problem is that I'm always going to see him as the Riddler, and I'm always going to see him as the shitty Riddler in the fucking Joel Kinnaman. I did not like his Riddler.
Hold on.
Are you talking about Jim Carrey and not Nicolas Cage? Yes, are you
I'm,
like
I'm Mr. totally I'm totally talking about Jim Carrey and not Nicolas Cage.
Oh, that's
that wow. That's sacrilege, sir. How wow. dare you?
Yeah.
Who'd him be?
Shit.
I don't know. I'm going to abstain. I mean, I want to see him do some wild out role. Like, I want to see him do Legion. Like, I want to see him be 7 different people and all of them be different. But okay. But I don't think...
He doesn't have that range.
Nicolas Cage?
What?
No, Nicolas Cage does not have that range to be 7 different people.
McAvoy will pull it off.
Yeah, okay. McElroy.
Could you have seen Nicolas Cage do Split?
No.
Really? All right.
No.
I respect your opinion. I can
see. But you know I'm an anti-Cage guy. Like, I think he's a shitty actor, so I think his whole persona of acting is just screaming on camera.
Okay.
But I think Gus's choice was phenomenal, so Gus.
All right, so when I got the notification, I honestly was agreeing with Josh. Two-Face would have been like the easy answer, but the one I would put Nicolas Cage on would be Clayface.
Ah, see, I could take that all day. Yes,
that would be amazing. Yeah. Clayface is an actor. Nicolas Cage is an actor. Clayface is over the top. Nicolas Cage is hella over the top.
But wait, if he's over the top, you're just saying that he has no range. So what is it?
His range is over the top, like all day, every day. He has one speed, and that's fucking supernova.
And yeah. But he's great. I love him as an actor, man. I like, seriously. Game tight, real quick. You said you want to see him in a real grit movie. Could you explain that?
Like a Western?
Go watch Ghostlands of the whatever.
Oh, that was horrible. No, no. Yeah. Fuck you, Vic.
Don't do that. Don't.
Fuck you.
While we're waiting for Cuzzo to answer, I got a little bit of a curveball for you guys. How would you feel about Jeffrey Dean Morgan being in a Marvel or DC? And where would you put him?
I don't even know who that is, so I'll have to look it up.
Negan.
No, Negan?
Yeah.
From The Walking Dead.
Okay, wait. You said Jeffrey Dean Morgan in a Marvel or DC movie as a villain?
Wherever you want to put him.
No, if you're going to put him in a fucking DC movie, he has to be Thomas Wayne and does the Batman shit. I'm sorry.
Okay, that's a good one.
Because
he's
the one he played Thomas Wayne in was it Justice League? No. Batman v Superman.
So I would say let him gray out his beard and do the Batman version of
Absolutely.
What's the I forget the show now.
Batman Beyond?
Yes, Batman Beyond. Let him be the mentor to the young Batman.
Nope. That will always be Michael Keaton on me.
I knew you were gonna say that.
Of course. All fucking day. Vic? I'll even take fucking Batfleck, you know what I'm saying, as the old version of Bruce. Game tight, you said no, like a horror movie grit, but he's the bad guy. A movie where he's the villain. I would love to fucking see that shit. I am not even gonna front.
With
I would
Nick
love
Cage,
to see
he's done shit like that. Like in those B movies, I watched a movie where he basically played Walter White. He was a coke cook, and it was about cocaine being transported and how it starts in the coca fields up until the point where it gets to Seattle with him and Lawrence Fishburne, and Lawrence Fishburne is a pimp. I watch a lot of really weird films. And he played this like gritty, weird character. If you haven't seen Pig yet, check out Pig.
I ain't watching that garbage. This is the guy that recommended Willy's Wonderland, the most horrible, asinine, stupid, crappy, can't believe they wasted time to make this fucking movie of a movie.
All right, so I would have the only one to co-sign that movie, okay?
Well, yeah, I would never, by the way. But I'm going to say this. I know, you know what I'm saying, Vic could definitely recommend some crazy over-the-top shit. That's Vic.
I can,
Vic
too.
Vic watches movies, you know what I'm saying? Vic, let me tell you, can recommend some great fucking shows. I'll tell you that right now, with the exception of one that I could not stand. But, nonetheless, we went to go see a Nick Cage movie, and to me, I won't watch it again, but I do like the fucking movie. Because it's such a, like, it's over-the-top, and like, I was just like, I can't believe I didn't pay for this shit. I'm glad. But like, if I would have paid for this, I would have been, offended. But it was such a good movie because it kept you, you know what I'm saying? It kept you engaged.
Are you talking about Pig?
No. What was that fucking movie that we went to go see?
The Unbearable Weight of Massive Talent.
The one where... Oh, guys did go see that?
Yeah, we ended up going to see it after Mr. Dunderbach and... My beef is I like my Pedro Pascal a certain way. I like certain Pedro Pascals, and I didn't like this Pedro Pascal. So I think that's what ruined it for me. And then there was an issue with the video, and I feel like we missed part of the movie, but I wasn't going to go argue because I got the movie tickets for $4. So it just became a thing. I'll watch it again. I'll see if I liked it. It wasn't the Nicolas Cage movie I wanted. Yeah, it was not the Nicolas Cage movie that I wanted.
But you were super hyped for this movie.
I was super hyped for this movie. I was so hyped, I was going ham. Liverpool were playing Everton. I was getting sausage and beer. Like, it was a thing. Like, game plan.
Bro.
Hell yeah.
But this shit was hilarious that he walked into the theater, nothing was playing. Like, mad people were in there, but nothing was playing. So I'm like, all right, I got to hurry up. I'm like, yo, you got to grab the soda. And I walk in and he's like, yo, nothing's playing. I'm like, oh shit, did I miss it? I'm like, what the fuck is going on? He's like, nah, you didn't miss it. We're the loudest ones in the fucking theater, bro.
Fucking teenagers.
Loudest ones. Okay? And then, like the first 15 minutes of the movie, gone. They didn't even fucking show that shit.
Bro. What movie theater did you go to? Like, some AMC. Hobo in a cardboard box?
No, we went to the AMC 24 over here at Highwoods. All right, let's unwrap...
I do want to see what he's talking about, though, because Game Tight was like, where the DC villain wins, something different. He's like, imagine a DC movie in the style of Saw. I'm sorry. I think DC did
something like that. We kind of got that, though. But we kind of got that in the Batman.
Yeah.
No, not like
that. The Batman was dark, man. The Batman was dark,
but not as gritty and not as fucking horrific as what Saw would be.
The closest that we've gotten to that is The Watchmen, and that's the closest you're ever going to see them do with properties like that.
I'll tell you what. Give me Constantine.
Nah, The Boys.
That kind of shit.
But that, is that DC?
No. But I'm just saying. Which comes back soon.
Yes.
Yeah, I have that a little later on in our conversations here. She-Hulk.
Trash. Fiona.
Do we even want to discuss it? Like, I mean, fuck. I mean, everybody.
I think it's gonna be great. The only complaint that I have, and Gus is gonna say, is it because I like chicks with muscles? I wish She-Hulk had a little more muscle on her. But I think it's going to be fucking awesome.
She was never that muscular. She was like toned and like, you know, shredded, but she was never that muscular.
Bro, but the previews, the previews when she turns into the She-Hulk, there was no muscle. She wasn't even toned. She was just green.
Because that was fucking Princess Fiona.
I think it's going to be good.
Shrek's going to guest
appear. You watch. You're going to be eating your words, Josh. Like, damn, that show was good.
Then you're going to see Donkey coming out of nowhere. I thought this was fucking Marvel. No, fuck that shit. Trash. Complete and utter trash.
I have a feeling that there's going to be enough complaints about this where now this show's going to get delayed the same way they did Sonic. Because the way people were upset about the CGI.
Trash. Nope. Disney has a plan, son. Marvel is not deviating from the plan for She-Hulk.
Who? So, do we know, is Feige directing Feige. This one, too?
Feige is not directing shit.
Feige's an executive producer, no.
Who's directing She-Hulk?
All right, let's dig into the internet.
Producers, can we get the notes on that?
Oh, mighty Google, we come to you once again.
Mike Myers. Mike Myers is directing the shit.
Yeah, don't sleep on the Pensavert, son.
Yo, let me tell you, I heard that he came out with a new show and shit, so I gotta
watch. Bro, that shit, he's trying too hard in that, Vic. He's trying way too hard in that.
He's fucking Mike Myers. Why wouldn't he be trying too hard?
Him and Nicolas Cage need to do a movie together. They'd be perfect for each other.
I'd watch that.
Here's my beef with the Pensavert. You watch So I Married an Axe Murderer. His father talks about this evil organization. I haven't finished it. I have an episode left. She-Hulk.
Of course he did.
I wanted to savor it. Fuck you. Don't judge me.
Someone loves Nick Cage.
So here's a fun fact. Listen to this shit. She-Hulk Attorney at Law will premiere August 17 on Disney Plus. The show is written by television veteran Jessica Gao, Rick and Morty.
For She-Hulk?
And Silicon Valley, and will be directed by Kat Corio. Corio. I don't know who that is.
I won't fucking watch it. I don't even watch fucking Rick and Morty.
Dude. If you don't watch Rick and Morty, get off the stream. Bye. Bye, Felicia.
Listen, I watched one show, and that one show was just of them destroying other versions of themselves.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
That's what makes the show fucking great. Bro, the show's so in-depth that you don't even know if Morty's the real Morty anymore.
Morty doesn't even know if he's the real Morty.
Yeah, and that's the whole point.
Yes, that's what's awesome about the show.
Oh, Silicon Valley, Robot Chicken. Yeah, she's written for a bunch of different shit, Jessica Gao.
Sounds like it's going to have some comedy in there.
Thanks, look, Captain. I know you're going to watch it anyway, Beast. You may not like it, but you're going to watch it anyway.
I have to. Because if we're going to fucking have any kind of content of me not liking a fucking show, I have to watch it. You have the villain Frogman in this shit.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Bro, there's that fucking scene where the guy's like...
And they show Abomination, and Wong is going to be in the series.
Of course. It's fucking Marvel. Why not? You have the, the Incredible Hulk. But they have the guy... There was that one scene where the guy's like, so we should... You know, this is like, the first date in a long time. We should order some fries. And she's like, we should take it to go. And she's carrying the motherfucker.
Yeah, that's like, awesome. That's awesome. You didn't find that funny? That was great. The dude's all buff, and She-Hulk's like, yeah, we going to Pound Town, motherfucker.
Well, she's going to be pegging his ass. No. Fuck that. Like I said, trash. Fucking trash.
I'm going to watch it. I am a little disappointed in the CGI. But yeah, I think it's going to be a good show.
I think it's going to be good. Marvel hasn't let me down yet besides the Eternals. Eternals can go fuck themselves, but everything else has been okay.
Besides the Eternals, what about the Inhumans?
What about Howard the
Duck? Hey, Howard the Duck's pretty good.
Now that Gus has seen the movie, just the little bit of Inhumans that you got, was it worth it to get Mason Mount?
Yes.
Thank you. So that's all I'm going to say. The littlest shit they do still has a bigger payoff, and that's what Marvel's secret is. They can say we're going to do shitty CGI on She-Hulk because we're going to have a bigger master to serve. And that's the only way I look at Marvel at this point. I roll with every punch they give me because the payoff, I think, is going to be there. Am I wrong for that?
Hold on. Wait. Iron Fist sucked.
Horrible. Yeah, Iron Fist was horrible.
Did Iron Fist pay off at any point? Did we get anything else with Iron Fist?
No, and that's the sad part. Like, we didn't even get, Defenders? I like Defenders.
Defenders sucked, too.
No, it didn't. No, it didn't. Jessica Jones sucked.
Jessica Jones was better than Iron Fist.
Jessica Jones was fucking awesome.
It was not.
Can I ask a question of the stream? Was that zombie Doctor Strange Defender Strange?
Yes, that was the... Oh, what a fucking low blow.
So I'm going to take a piss. I'll be back. I'll let you guys discuss amongst yourselves. The possibilities are endless.
Well, that's why it's called the multiverse. Because they can do whatever
all over our faces.
You're absolutely, and we're gonna fucking sit there and pay for that shit. Well, yep. Y'all niggas will. I won't. So anyway, game tight. Let me ask you a question real quick, homie. Have you seen Doctor Strange? Real talk. I just while you come up with, you know, you're typing and shit like that, I just need to know if you saw Doctor Strange 2, not 1, 2. But yes, no, the possibilities of what they did, like, I did not like the way they fucking, you know what I'm saying? I hope you don't mind spoilers, homie, because, you know.
Spoiler notification.
Well, it's been out for a minute now, so.
Yo, I'll tell you what, my man. I'll tell you what. Yo, game tight. Holler at me on the slide real quick. If you get a fire stick, my man, I got you, bro. You
know what I'm saying? These movies do exist on the internet. That's all I'm going to say.
Exactly. But I got you, homie. I got you. So, bro, like, I get it. I'm there with you. I'm there with you. I do it because, it, you know what I'm saying, the wife likes to, you know what I'm saying, cuddle and shit like that. And you got to have something in the background. But anyway, so, like, the way they fucking killed off, you know what I'm saying, fucking...
Reed Richards?
Yeah, there we go. Had a break.
Everybody.
Everybody, yeah.
She fucking, like, straight up soloed, you know what I'm saying, the fucking Illuminati. I give her props. She really is that OP, even in the comics. But she's even more OP in the comics than what we even saw in that movie. All right.
Yeah, but picture this. She's that OP that she was in another version of herself, and she was still OP. Like, it wasn't...
Yeah, because no matter what version you get of her, she's that OP regardless. But that was the point of it, you know what I'm saying? And she's going through, she's dreamwalking fantastic regardless. And like I said, the way she killed off Richards, I'm sorry, but the smartest man alive wouldn't have fucking sat there and said, he can kill you with a whisper. Like, shut the fuck up.
Yeah. Well, we talked about this on the last stream too.
Yeah, and I fucking missed it. But you know what I'm saying? Like, the point is, they killed off the smartest man like that. I gotta say, I mean, granted, I get the whole...
The only reason why I think they did that is they just wanted to give you the taste of what the new Fantastic Four movie is going to have, you know, the actor fine. In it. I think that's the only reason why they had that cameo. I mean, I had a lot of beef with the Illuminati. Like I said, that was your opportunity to bring Robert Downey Jr. back. He founded the Illuminati. You could add fucking Iron Man back.
He didn't found it. He was one of, but he wasn't the reason why they got together. But you know, that's for another conversation, I guess. You're right. They could have brought Iron Man back. They could have brought him back in that particular one. They could have given us Tom Cruise as superior Iron Man. I was hoping for it. Really, really was. Do we want
Tom Cruise in the Marvel Universe?
No. I
don't want Tom Cruise in
the Marvel Universe.
Nope.
I said what I said.
Come on, man. That whole, like, when they showed the, you see that poster of, like, all the people they were going to cast as Marvel characters.
And Tom Cruise would have been a fucking fantastic replacement for Robert Downey Jr. in another universe. Absolutely.
I would rather see Nicolas Cage as Superman than Tom Cruise in the Marvel Universe.
Exactly. I will co-sign with Gus on that all day. Fuck Tom Cruise.
I said what I said.
In the Marvel Universe. Them battle-fitted boys have spoken.
I'd rather them bring back evil Robert Downey Jr. Iron Man before they give me Tom Cruise.
Well, that's what superior Iron Man is. I'll give you guys that. Fuck you both, all three of you.
Mad because we speak logic.
No, there was no logic behind that shit. I was excited because I thought we were going to get Tom Cruise.
Okay, but whatever. Why do you want to see Tom Cruise as Superior Iron Man? Why Tom Cruise?
Okay, so again, so when you look at a lot of the fan casting, okay, Krasinski was top for Reed Richards. And this goes back like fucking
years.
Right. 6-7 years, okay? Mm-hmm. So they took a fan cast and said, you know what? Let's go ahead and give the fans... Let's give them, you know, get their rocks off with this one little nugget.
And you know, now there's rumors that Emily Blunt may play Sue Storm.
There's also there should be rumors about fucking Krasinski fucking directing this shit. He might as well do it.
All those things are going to happen. That is the power that he commands. Like, his wife will be on set with him, his kids will be on set with him, and he will direct that movie, and it will be ridiculous.
You got to remember, he also casted for Captain America.
You mean he auditioned?
Yeah, auditioned.
Get the nuts out of your mouth.
So, speaking of directors, that can take us into the next point, Vic.
Well, I got a question before you guys do that. Hold on. Who would you guys get to play The Thing? And Johnny Storm.
Who? Peter Dinklage. Oops, sorry.
I'm going to play The Thing, and who you cast as Johnny Storm, I don't care.
Ryan Reynolds as Johnny Storm.
I would take that. Unfortunately, it can never happen because you're getting Deadpool on fire, practically. No. I'll tell you what. If they give him a couple years and let him age, you know what I'm saying? I'll take the kid that played Ryan Reynolds as a younger one. All fucking day for Johnny Storm.
I can't wait that long.
Yeah, I was gonna say that's like fucking 10 years from now.
I'm telling you right now, it probably won't happen for another 5 or 6 years. Mm-mm. He'll be of age.
Nope, I can't wait. We need a Fantastic Four movie done properly.
Yeah, we need a proper Doctor Doom.
2 years ago.
Who would you get as Doctor Doom?
Elon Musk.
Tom Cruise.
I'll take either answer.
Negan can play Doctor Doom.
No, actually, I think that would be really a good one.
Yeah. He really could. I'll take it.
Yeah, so, Negan can be Doctor Doom.
So this
we had Nip Tuck for
Jeffrey Morgan.
I have Negan, but the problem is that he's 6 foot tall.
So,
isn't Doctor Doom huge?
No. Well, I want to see Negan as a grizzled older Wolverine.
So you want him to be another Logan?
Nope.
No.
Old man Logan.
Yeah. No. That if we're gonna get an older Wolverine, it has to be Hugh Jackman.
You gotta stick with Jackman.
Yeah.
Jackman's my Wolverine, just like Ryan Reynolds is my Deadpool. It's just the way it is.
Yep. Agreed.
I think Ryan Reynolds is everybody's Deadpool. I mean, shit.
Deadpool thinks Ryan Reynolds is his Deadpool. You know what I mean?
Rob, you're going to bring up directors. Which director did you want to bring up?
Well, no, I was talking about your other point where you were talking about a certain director going into Star Wars.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes. Like,
you got the call.
So Taika is supposedly next. But here's the concern. Because
I don't want it.
Shut your face.
I don't think you'll be good. I honestly, look, you know... You know I love all things Star Wars. You know, I mean, shit, I'm wearing my Not Today Star Wars shirt. You know, my house is full of Star Wars memorabilia. He's a look, he's a comedy director, man. Star Wars ain't funny. He's a comedy director. Look at one of my favorite movies, Ragnarok, comedy. What We Do in the Shadows, comedy. Our Flag Means Death, comedy.
Sadly, I don't think Jojo he can. Rabbit comedy.
I don't think he can do. I don't think he can do Star Wars. I just don't.
Damn.
Beast.
I mean, he can prove me wrong, but I don't.
You're getting that 1,000-yard stare from Beast right now.
Haters gonna hate.
So wait. So you don't think he can go from comedic to serious?
And Free Guy comedy.
Hold on. I'm asking though. You don't think people can go from comedic to serious?
I think they can, but when like when you have a brand and you've been on that brand, it's hard to get out of it. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
well, I mean, that guy from Keenan and Peele did it, right?
Yeah. Yeah. That, but, oh my God, he's crazy. Comedic.
Yeah, but no, but he's crazy.
Yeah, slap ass.
Didn't Michael Keaton do Batman and he was a comedic character for a minute?
Yeah.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, but he didn't direct it.
But that's an actor. He's not a director.
So,
but what I'm saying is you can switch it up. You can go from comedic to serious.
Okay, so this is, and Beard, if I'm incorrect, please correct me. When you're an actor, you have the ability to have certain range. You can do comedy, you can do action, you can do drama, and you can fall into certain roles. When you're a director, you have a certain brand or style. So, for example, I love Tarantino. I never want him to touch a Star Trek movie. I know that I have in the past said that I want him to touch a Star Trek movie. After seeing just the snippets that I've seen of this Star Trek Enterprise or whatever this prequel is, I want him to go nowhere near Star Trek.
Because you know who I'd rather have than I can't. What's his name? I can't pronounce it.
Who? James Cameron.
No, the
who can't hold on? Who can't pronounce James Cameron?
Tahiti.
Taika Waititi.
Taika. I would rather have James Gunn direct a Star Wars movie.
I'll take that.
I think James Gunn would do a better job.
Wasn't it James Gunn and fucking J.J. Abrams going back and forth and like putting little details on their sets like to fuck with each other?
I don't know.
J.J. Abrams was doing Star Trek, and James Gunn was doing, of course, Guardians of the Galaxy, I think, at the time. And they were going back and forth. Gunn was putting... I can't remember what it was. It was like the Star Trek Enterprise on the bottom of the ship, and like they took pictures of it and sent it to him. Like they were going back and forth. I'm gonna find the article.
Taika could do something one off. Like he could do something with some droids. Like who was that droid when they showed up? Ninth movie.
You're talking about KSO?
Yes. So something like that where he's shooting, you know, this one-off which deals with, like, a particular type of story. Like, for example, if you were to give him the character that What's-Her-Face from Strangers with Candy plays on Mandalorian and, like, do, like, her garage, he could probably pull something like that off and make it amazing.
I think, I may be wrong, but I think Taika did direct some Mandalorian.
Yeah, no, he directed a couple, but it's a specific wheelhouse. To give him a full-on movie,
right? That's what I'm saying. I don't think it fits his brand or style. I love the dude, and once again, Ragnarok, one of my favorite movies, and my top, and my Marvel. I watch that all day, every day, all the damn time. Never get tired of it. But to go into Star Wars, I would rather have like Abramson and Gunn team up and do one or something, or you know, You can't top Lucas, man. Lucas needs to come back and just do some more.
Fuck Lucas no. is kicking back and collecting checks, bro. Yeah. He ain't gonna come back.
Yeah, George.
He don't need to.
George Lucas does not need to go anywhere near Marvel.
Yeah, I know. His family's is set for life.
It ain't even about the money. Just let it go. You created something. Let it be. Let it go. Where do we want to go? They're bringing back Married with Children, but they did it smart. They're doing a cartoon.
Are they gonna get the original cast to do the voiceovers? Yep.
They got the original cast.
What?
But can it be the same show?
Yeah, absolutely. It can.
It could be better, I think.
Yeah, they could even make it more raunchier. Look at all the adult cartoons that we have now.
Family Guy.
Do we know what channel it's going to be on?
That's the one thing I wasn't able to confirm. Actually, let me see if that's updated.
I mean, I love me some Family Guy, man.
I don't think Married with Children would go back to Fox though.
Family Guy and Bob's Burgers, that's my shit.
They're making a Bob's Burger movie.
And my wife hates Bob's Burgers with a passion, man. I love that shit.
Why?
Just the voices being annoying.
She's not wrong.
Yeah, they are annoying.
Please don't be on Fox. Please don't be on Fox.
The Orville's coming back too. Finally,
Sony Pictures Television.
Oh, then that's going to be a syndication.
They're probably going to put it on a streaming service.
Yeah,
like Paramount Plus.
I was going to say Paramount Plus or something.
Well, speaking of the shit that's getting announced, Married with Children, The Orville. I didn't even know The Boys was coming. June 3rd. June 23rd, Umbrella Academy.
Umbrella Academy.
Oh, yeah. I love that shit. That's a good show.
So we've been getting, like, drops left and right. The one that concerns me, the one that I have a big, big fear on. Actually, you know what? Before I do that, Rob, have you seen Undone?
No.
So it's this, like, cel-shaded cartoon. I want to say it was 6 episodes on Amazon. Check it out. It's a pretty decent and solid show. The one that's coming back that really fucking concerns me, and it's gone. Are you kidding me? Wow. And I didn't put it in the notes because I wanted to bring up a big point about the fact that this show was coming back. And now my concern is that it's coming back. And it's gone. Okay, so maybe it'll come back up. Stranger Things. When the fuck did they decide they're going to start doing 90-minute episodes?
What?
I never watched
the I think this is the final season, right?
Yeah, that's
why.
The series finale. This is it. Yeah.
They say makes the sense. Episodes range between 37 and, like, I want to say almost 137 minutes.
That's probably nuts. The final episode's going to be 2 hours. But think about it. That's it. The end of the story.
One thing I wish that Disney Plus would do, and, you know, Disney, if you're listening and you do this, just give me a little bit of fucking kickback. Just a little bit of mouse kickback. After they release, like, Mandalorian or Book of Boba Fett or any of the Marvel movies, put it where you can just watch it all the way through, where you don't have to go episode to episode, almost like a movie.
Oh,
you saying continuous play?
Yeah, just take the whole. So, like, there's 10 episodes of Mando. After it airs, you can watch that ten episodes, because they're only like, what, 30 minutes a piece or something,
mm-hmm.
all the way through to the end without any interruptions, without having to go into another episode.
Okay.
You can call it continuous play. Disney, you hear me? Me and Gus, we need a little bit of kickback for that one. Let's go.
I just need some boxing gloves.
Why, you want to bust somebody's ass?
No, actually.
What happened to your boxing gloves?
Oh, man, they're worn out. Foam's gone. What, Josh?
Nothing. Nothing.
What? You're biting your lip.
I'm holding back. I'm not gonna go there. I'm just gonna leave it alone.
You turned him on when you said the foam's worn out. That's why he was biting his lip.
Either you're biting your lip or you're missing your mustache. Which is it?
Wow. Still not going there. Just gonna leave my reserve my comics for myself.
Yeah. Keep that one in the bag, bro. No worries. You're good.
Speaking of Star Wars, Vic, I think you said something about that Solo convinced Disney to no longer cast actors as classic Star Wars characters. What's up with that?
So, based off of the situation that happened with Solo and them bringing in, I'm assuming not Donald Glover, but the other guy, that they do not want to recast characters younger. So we wouldn't have seen the guy come in and play Solo. We wouldn't have seen the guy come in and play Lando. Either original properties or find a way to make it work. My concern is, do we now not get Sebastian Stan as Luke because that's all that I could want at this point. Because I can't expect Mark Hamill to be alive forever, and CGI can only go so far. But I'm okay if they hand it off to Sebastian Stan and say, okay, just go be Luke Skywalker.
I liked the Solo movie, though, so I didn't see anything wrong with
it. I loved the Solo movie. I thought
that was a good movie. Was
fucking great. I thought the three offs were great.
Well, Rogue One is the shit. I mean, that's a great movie.
All three were outstanding movies.
I didn't see Rogue One, unfortunately.
What?
Bro, you got to check out Rogue One. You got to. If you care any little bit about Star Wars, you got to. If not, take that Thor hammer, Lego Thor hammer behind you and hit yourself.
You like that, right?
Hard.
You like that, right?
You really trying to flex? Did you not see last week's stream? Like,
No. That just that actually just got up here today because remember I've been locked in my room, so I had to find a place for that. I'm actually gonna be taking all these movies down and then replacing with the Legos and all that shit and adding more Legos to it. I'm trying to catch up with Brax over here, bro. Like,
not gonna happen.
I got some time, bro.
You're lucky I can't pick up the iPad and show you the 1989 Batwing I'm currently building that's sitting on a table and it's like this fucking big.
Bro, I wanted that shit, but I couldn't justify spending almost $200 for that shit.
Yeah, you ain't
catching
up. Bro, not right now. Not right now.
Responsibilities.
Yeah. Right now, yeah, I got some catching up to do. I missed some time at work and shit, so I got some catching up to do.
Fair enough.
But I'll catch up.
But back to what we...
That was a gift, though.
Back to what we were saying, I think that's bullshit, man. Like, if we want more lore in the Star Wars universe, they have to show, you know, what happened in the past.
Yep. I mean, they did it with the 1, 2, and 3.
Are you talking about Clone Wars, Phantom Menace, and Revenge of the Sith? Yeah, and you see how that turned out, right? Fantastic. A lot of people... Yeah, but it did also catch a lot of fucking flack.
Why?
A lot.
Anakin, the whole Annie as a kid. And believe it or not, that kid from playing Annie, his life got completely fucked up because of it. Like, he never did acting again after that because, like, people would not let him live that. The fans were, like, atrocious to him and would not let him live that role down.
Really?
Yeah. Ewan just came out and was like, we're finally getting love for those movies. Finally, after all these years.
Star Wars fans, I hate to say it, are some of the most toxic-ass fans around. I'm a guy who loves all things Star Wars. I love all the movies, all the universe, all the bullshit. And there's just some people that they will have nothing but hate and discontent for certain pieces of Star Wars.
So, new rumor, Margot Robbie potentially taking over in Pirates. And now, supposedly, Johnny is not off the table. So, would you take Margot? Would you take Johnny? Would you take them both? Would you take neither?
Johnny Depp is off the table, man. He ain't going back to that shit.
I've read, like, yeah, originally he was off the table, but now that it looks like Amber Heard's just a crazy bitch.
No, that, he said it himself.
That Johnny Depp may get some reparations, so.
Nah, he said it himself. In court, he will not go back to that shit.
Bro, anybody says they're not going to do some shit until Disney throws a fucking fat paycheck in front of your face.
Yep.
This is true.
I said I was never going to eat a Mexican pizza again. And then what happened? Taco Bell made Mexican pizzas.
And that's the multiverse, motherfucker.
Yep.
If they were able to get Johnny back, I would like to see both of them in there.
Who would Margot Robbie be playing?
She's going to be the face of it. Like, she would be... If she comes in, from what I understood on the article, they're going to revamp the franchise. So
look, they can take Pirates of the Caribbean and with the, you know, Indiana Jones and Star Wars and all the Disney storytelling, they can make three prequel movies with Margot Robbie, and maybe she teaches a young Jack Sparrow to be Jack Sparrow. Who knows? Like, the fucking sky's the limit with these damn movies, man. Like, look at... They just said they're going to continue to pump out Harry Potter. Let Harry Potter fucking die, man. They're going to continue to pump it out. Like,
well, I read something today that was kind of interesting. So, if they were to give you... Well, what are your feelings on Harry Potter overall? Are you a Potterhead, or do you not fucks with Harry Potter?
No, I've watched every last single movie except for the Secrets of Dumbledore, the new ones, and I like up into Fantastic Beasts, but the last movie after that, it was garbage. It was hot garbage. So I think they're just going too far now.
Give it about 10 years and you could get a nice Harry Potter show. 8 seasons, 8 books. Would you watch it?
Yeah, hell yeah. I'm a fucking nerd till I die, man. Lord of the Rings series is coming out. That's going to be badass. Dude, this is for us as adults, if you like this shit, this is a glorious time to be alive, man. We get everything. Everything right now.
Ooh,
and I consume all of it. Just gobble, gobble, gobble.
So you brought up LOTR. Do you know that fucking Nicolas Cage was supposed to be Aragorn?
Oh, my God. Nicolas Cage. Fuck that dude, man. I'm glad he wasn't, man. Viggo Mortensen is the shit.
He did not. So Viggo Mortensen was actually the third choice. The dude who played, because he was number two in another movie. Regardless, it was supposed to be Nick Cage, then this other guy, and then we got Viggo. Glad we got Viggo. Did you know that Nick Cage was supposed to be Neo? He didn't want to go to Australia for 2 years. Smith. So Nick Cage had the chance to be Aragorn and Neo, and because he didn't want to take a trip, he lost out on those roles.
Bro. I mean, Will Smith was supposed to be Neo too, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, well, I'm glad.
Bro, let's talk about Daniel Radcliffe as Weird Al Yankovic. I can't wait to see that
bro, show. Bro, that shit looks hilarious.
Like that.
Shit's gonna be good, man. That shit looks good.
Oh, speaking of Will Smith, did you hear the rumor going around?
What now?
What, that he's gay?
No, that Jada's supposedly pregnant with someone else's kid.
Get the fuck out of here.
I hope, you know what?
What month of the year is she pregnant with now?
You know what? I hope it's true. I hope it's true.
This supposedly happened in February where she was kind of hinting that she was pregnant.
I hope it's true, and I hope that's the straw that breaks the camel back and Will fucking bounces.
Get the fuck out of here, Jay.
I feel so bad. I mean, yeah, it's his own life and he dug his own grave, but I feel so fucking bad for that dude.
I can't even bring myself to watch King Richard. I can't even bring myself to watch a Will Smith movie because I'm so
I haven't watched it. Well, I actually that other night that I was at work on post, I watched Hancock.
Hancock's a great movie though.
I love that fucking movie.
Hancock is a solid flick.
I did recently watch a Will Smith flick.
Will Smith has bangers. Don't get me wrong. Like, I'm not
I am
Will
Legend.
Smith hater. I Am Legend, great movie. I, Robot, great
movie. I, Robot.
He's got... What was the one that he did with Margot Robbie? Not Suicide Squad, the other one.
Oh, the heist one? Yeah.
I did the name of it, but... He did Ali?
Yeah.
Ali was great. Ali.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he's got some bangers, man.
Ali was awesome.
Will Smith just happens to be in a real effed up situation. Someone who's not in an effed up situation, I was going to talk about Cocaine Bears because we had Cocaine Hippos. And in
it was
the
called
80s. Focus. All the Will Smith Margot Robbie movie.
Focus.
There was a bear that found a duffel bag full of cocaine and got all hopped up on cocaine. And I thought that would have been amazing to talk about, but it's getting late. And
like a hey boo boo, real like
yeah, like a
real
black, bear. Like a black bear. I don't know if he was snorting coke or if he was eating.
Why you gotta be black and finding cocaine?
Well, that's what the article said. I can't change facts, you know. Skies are blue, water's wet. But I'm gonna push this out. I wanted to end this on this. So. How many people saw the Super Bowl last year, or at least the Super Bowl's commercials? Not this year, last year. 2021. We were locked down in COVID football. Okay, do you remember when Michael B. Jordan came on as the new Alexa voice?
Yes, unfortunately.
Okay. Sonos has decided to make their own Alexa, and they're going to use Giancarlo Esposito. Tell me there is no better voice than Gustavo Fring saying yes. When you ask him for something.
Well, I mean, here's the other thing. I'm all about, you know, Amazon, if you're listening, you know, I got Disney an idea. Amazon, just in the app, give us the option to change the voice to whatever the fuck we want so we can have customization of that shit.
Google used fuck to do it. I me. Had John Legend and I had, what's had, her name?
Barack the chick Obama. From,
they had Barack.
For Google, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Dude, so right now, if I go into Waze, Master Chief talks to me and my little car is a warthog. So Waze has a garbage-ass GPS service, has customization. You're telling me Amazon can't let me pick a few different voices?
Pause. Fucking Waze talks to you?
Yes.
Waze talks.
Yes. And, and they put...
I use dude, Waze, but I never heard
dude, they put me. Master Chief's voice in Waze, and he says, all right, he says crazy-ass shit like, all right, guys, let's roll out, and shit like... There's danger up ahead. Be cautious. Like, dude, like, they really put some thought into this, and your little car is a damn warthog driving down the radio, driving down the road.
Get the fuck out of here.
That's pretty badass. I know I had Cookie Monster.
Yeah, they have all kinds of, they have tons of different things you can select and waste, but Amazon can't give me a different voice?
Wasn't Snoop Dogg in one of them, too?
I think so.
Bartman or something?
They all kinds, man.
Yeah, well, my Siri's an Englishman with an Indian accent because I just feel comfortable. Hearing an Englishman with an Indian accent just makes me feel good. Final thoughts, gentlemen.
Go ahead, Beast.
I'm still on this whole fucking Waze has, like, different voices.
Whoa, I'm sorry that you chose to multitask on a podcast. Let somebody
I've always
else
multitasked.
Go for-
I just suck at it. I didn't say I was good at it.
Final thought is check out Waze, and maybe you can find the Master Chief as your voice on Waze.
Gus? Actually, no. I got a final thought.
Thank you.
So, I was actually intrigued by this only murderers in the building with Martin Short and
I
love Steve Martin and Martin Short, and the fact that they're together again, they haven't been together that much like that, you know, on like a show or anything like that, or yeah, I mean I think
Three Amigos,
yeah, exactly. So the fact that they're together in a fucking show is hilarious. I don't care how good or how bad this fucking show is, they got these two together. That's fucking awesome. That's like putting, if you know, if he was alive still, you know what I'm saying, Robin Williams with fucking, what was his name, Billy Crystal, putting those two in a fucking movie would be gold.
Okay, so all is right. That your final thought and recommendation?
That's my final thought and recommendation.
Alright, fair enough.
And fuck COVID.
And fuck
COVID. Fuck COVID.
Beard?
I don't really have a final thought, but my recommendation, and even though I'm recommending this, I think it's like one of the most horrible movies I ever watched in my life. Everything, Everywhere, All at Once came out before Doctor Strange. It is a multiverse type movie, and I still have no idea what the message behind the movie was. But it does have some wild ass visuals. It does have I don't know the actress's name, but she was in Crazy Rich Asians. She was in Shang-Chi. Her in the movie and like the different things that she goes through in the movie. It's a one watcher, but it's horrible. But you see the visuals and you're like, it's a far out movie, man. It's like I felt like I was high without being high while watching the movie.
Felt like that in Doctor Strange.
So check that out. Everything, Everywhere, All at Once.
Okay. Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna get a little serious here for a second. So one thing we haven't talked about is May is Mental Health Awareness Month, right? It's month. So
it should be every month.
It should be every month, right? The other day, Rob, when we got to the gym, one of the members that always says hi to us, it comes up to me and he says, and I see you, you're in here and you're doing work and you're really pushing yourself and it's starting to show. That little compliment that he gave me made my day. Like, it was nice to see that my efforts and my hard work and folks are noticing. So my final thought would be, you know, if you see someone doing something, you know, give them a compliment. Like, I think as men, sometimes we shy away from doing that to one another. It's like, hey, dude, good job. I see you're doing your thing. The other thing is, you know, being that it's Mental Health Awareness Month, if you need help, ask for it, dude. There's a lot of avenues. There's a lot of people out there that are struggling with the same thing that you might be struggling with. I've been blessed to have you guys, and I take everything that you guys say to me and really take it to heart and really think about it. The other day I did post something in my Instagram. It was a quote that's an old Chinese proverb that says, it is better to be a warrior in a garden than a gardener at war. And that's really deep because it means so much. A warrior is going to appreciate the garden more because that is now his time of peace where he can rest and enjoy the many wonders of life. Be a warrior, take care of yourself, and that's my final thought. Yeah, recommendation.
You just set me up for
you always choose to go last after we've been profound and gave some motivational hoorah, get off your ass speech, man. Well, I mean,
the whole thing was that the first couple of weeks it was usually toilet humor and me, you know, suggesting something funny, and then
wait, pause. First couple of weeks, bro, you did that shit for like a year straight, bro.
Fine, all right, a year straight. Tacking on to Mental Health Awareness Month. Find somebody that you haven't spoken to in a while. And just send a message. I'm not telling you to make a phone call. I'm not telling you to, you know, send smoke signals. Just send one message. Whether they respond or not, just send something as encouragement. Just like Gus kind of talked about. My second thought or recommendation is going to be Mexican pizzas are back. Taco Bell did it right. I'm sorry. You know, I mean, Gus.
Taco Bell is not even Mexican food, man.
Yeah, it's American bastardized, but the Mexican pizza is just a thing. And they seem to fry their gorditas now. I don't know how they do it, but they fry it in nacho cheese dust. And it's fucking delicious. So send a message to someone that you love that you haven't spoken to in a while. Don't expect a response. Just send something out of kindness. The reason why you give a gift is not with the expectation of getting something in return. So even if it isn't something physical you're buying for somebody, just send some love somebody's way. They might need it. Second, go to Taco Bell. Go get you one of those Mexican pizzas. Go get you one of these Doritos dusted fried gorditas. They are delicious. My third one is going to be an alcoholic beverage for everyone. It is called Screwball Peanut Butter Whiskey. 35% alcohol by volume. I've been told mix it with grape juice, it tastes like peanut butter and jelly. I've been told if you put it in cream soda or Dr. Pepper, it tastes like, you know, something peanut butter deliciousness. I like it warm and straight up. On that note, we are the Detention Podcast. It's been wonderful hanging out this Thursday evening. We thank you for giving us an hour and 38 minutes of your time. And we'll do this again next week. And hopefully we recorded. But most importantly, Josh, can you drop the link tree for me? Because I have one last thing I need to say.
I got one thing, if you guys can see this.
Rob, I'm already ahead of you, Rob. I got you, brother.
No, but look.
Oh, advanced to the top 10. Okay. So we have never asked you to spend money on this podcast. You get free votes. If you want to drop $10 for a vote, you can do so. That'll help Rob get this food business off the ground. And then
Currently first.
You know what?
Look at first that. Place.
I have 6 days. We have 6 days to get me to the top five now.
22 hours, 13 minutes, and 54 seconds.
To get me to the top five.
To the top five. If you've never given us any money, we have never asked you for any money, spend them on votes. Get this man to where he needs to be because he's got t-shirts. We've got things we've got to do. We've got a podcast that we want to grow to share with all of you. Because, yo, at the end of the day, we just happen upon each other and nothing but love has come from it. On that note, I'd like to ask for a detention salute to everyone watching the podcast. We will see you again next Thursday, fuckers.
Peace, have a bitches.
Wonderful night.
Pew, pew, pew.
Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew.